cybersecurity threats are all around us. From hackers causing mischief, to organized crime syndicates pursuing financial gain, to nation-states conducting espionage. The primary goal of cybercriminals is to gain access to corporate and/or personal data. The value of this data isn't just for primary use, for instance, opening new credit card accounts or hacking into a company server. A vibrant market exists in the deep web for selling credentials and sensitive information to other cybercriminals. In this video, we cover some of the best practices to protect sensitive information and your own privacy. Responsible information management begins with understanding the types of data being handled and classifying it accordingly. The growth of social collaboration and new ways of collecting data and storing content exposes organizations to evolving security risks. Microsoft Azure Information Protection lets people classify, label, and protect the content they use, both inside and outside of organizational boundaries. This technology can also automate the classification for content that has sensitive information in it, such as credit card numbers or social security numbers. Five classifications define the level of protection applied to emails and content. Personal is used for personal use only and only contains non-business data. Public is used for business data specifically prepared and approved for public consumption. General is used for business data not intended for public consumption, but can be shared with external partners as required. Confidential is used for sensitive business data that could cause damage to the business if shared with unauthorized people. Examples include contracts, sales reports, and security assessments. Highly confidential is used for very sensitive business data, such as personal employee and customer information, passwords, and pre-announced financial reports. While our best practice video on securing your identity discussed how you can protect your credentials, this video goes deeper into how IT organizations can manage end-user credentials and their access to sensitive data and applications. Identity and access management enables the right individuals to access the right resources at the right times for the right reasons. Employees are granted authorization based on business needs and in alignment with the identity and access management policy and process. Multifactor authentication is a method of authentication that requires the use of more than one verification method and adds a critical second layer of security to user sign-ins and transactions. This may also be referred to as a two-factor authentication when only two methods of verification are needed. Multifactor authentication works by requiring any two or more verification methods, which would include something you know, typically a password or PIN, something you have, such as a trusted device like a phone, and something you are, your fingerprint, facial shape, or other unique attribute that can't be replicated. Users and systems should only have the minimum level of access necessary to perform their defined function. All unnecessary levels of access should be disallowed. Privileges should be allocated on a need-to-know basis and, where possible, event by event, so that accounts have only the minimum level of access for their functional role and only for as long as needed to complete the task. For access to sensitive infrastructure, applications, and data, we recommend using a strategy of just-in-time and just-enough administrator access. Microsoft's just-in-time administrative service not only grants time-limited administrator access, but allows tracking and auditing of privileged accounts to control the amount of privilege access to sensitive resources. Persistent administration credentials leave many organizations exposed to harm, as intruders can use them to navigate laterally on the network and cause further harm. Our customers can leverage these best practices and more via our enterprise identity, security, and cybersecurity technologies such as Azure Security Center, Microsoft Advanced Threat Analytics, Azure Information Protection, Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection, and Windows Defender. Maintaining appropriate protections for data based on its value or risk for the organization is the cornerstone for privacy. and tightly controlling access to infrastructure, applications, and data to those who have a business need, and only for the time needed, is a critical step in helping ensure your organization is protected from intrusion and disruption. Taking the appropriate steps will help protect your sensitive information and your own privacy, both online and offline.